Hello everyone, you share these two designs with us and I'll be showing you in detail how to make this purple dress, and using the same methods you can make even this blue dress. The only difference is you have to cut the sleeves of the blue dress on bias, asymmetrical, keep the neck deep, and there would be some gathers on the waist. So stay subscribed and press the bell button so that you receive all the latest videos and latest designs. These are the measurements that you need: full length, body's length. Skirt length would be full length minus the body's length. You can make this dress in any length, as long as you want or as short as you need. These are some of the tools that you need: scale, scissors, inch tape or the measuring tape, and chalk, pencil with the paper, tracing wheel. This is the zipper or buttons you can use, but I'm using zipper for the back. The same color reel, chalk, and a press. That's very essential. Now this is the fusing or buckram canvas which you will be using for the collar. Now we need about 3 meter fabric for a small size, and you can add up 1/2 inch for bigger sizes. Now we cut front and back bodies together. This is the fabric. I'm using cotton fabric because it's summertime, and then we folded the back side of the fabric would be out, and then we fold. Pay attention how it is folded, because we have to keep an opening on the back. So I'm placing the fabric this way. Now we keep about 1/4 part of chest plus 3 inches more. This I mark on the folded side of the fabric, and then I place it so that we don't waste fabric. If you watch the entire video, then you'll understand the video better. So this is the folded side, and I keep the scale parallel to it to check the length that we need. You can keep it till your armhole, or till waist length, or till hip length, as short or as long as you want. I'm keeping about 16 inches, 1 inch extra, 1/2 inch for below seam and 1/2 inch for upper. Now we extend this line. This is the bottom. Now we'll start marking from the folded side of the fabric. Okay, from here we'll start marking the shoulder, that is 1/2 shoulder plus 1/4 inch. Now this side we need about 1.5 inch extra for the back placket. I'm using a zipper, but you can use even a button hold or some loop buttons, etc., whatever you want. Then from the folded side, remember we are cutting front and back together, so we mark armhole, that is same as the shoulder, 7.5. Waist length 14.5, that is optional. Neck length, that is front neck length or neck depth, that is 3.5 inch or 3 inch. Neck width 3 inch. Now we shape the front neck. This is our front neck. You can add the collar, or you can add the placket even in front if you are keeping it close from the back. Now we mark the chest line. Chest line is fourth part of chest plus half inch if you want it fit, but as shown in the design, it is a loose dress, so you can keep it 1 inch loose, like fourth part of chest plus 1 inch. Waist, here also you can keep it quarter of an inch lesser than the chest line. On the hip line, we are making a dart for a good fitting on the waist, that is 3 inch inside or 3.5 inch inside and about 4 inch long. So the hip line, that would be fourth part of hip plus 1.5 inch extra, half inch for dart. Or you can keep it same as chest line. Now we shape the outer lines. We mark the armhole. So we take it half inch lesser than the shoulder. Join it from up. Take about half inch down for the shoulder slope. Back neck, we are keeping 1 inch down. We'll be adding the collar. So that's done. Now the armhole, middle, and then we can do freehand for the armhole, or we can use this armhole curve. This is easily available in the market. When you visit the market, you can get it easily, or you can order online as well, whatever is convenient to you. Using the armhole curve, we mark the inside armhole as well as the outer armhole. Because we are cutting front and back together, we keep 1 inch out from the sides for seams. Using the tracing wheel, we run on the dart and the side stitching line. Now we cut. This is the extra 1.5 inch for the back placket. And this is, here we go a slightly up, curvier from the bottom, middle of the dart for the, a small cut for the notch, a small cut here where our placket starts. This is our back neck, then shoulder slope, back armhole. Then side, right? This is back part cut, and here we make a small notch, so this will guide our back placket. We make, because the print is somewhat same from front and back, we make a mark so that we know what is the front side, what is the back side. This is the back side, okay, and this is the zipper. I have a small zipper, so I'll be using only half. But if you have a longer one, you can complete from up till bottom. This is the front. Now we cut the front neck. If you don't want to add the collar, you can add a bias tape or a bias strip. That is very easy. I've shown you many times. If you don't know, don't remember, you can ask me. I'll give you a link. Then we cut the front armhole, and this is how it looks like from the sides. It will be lesser once it is done. And now we have to add the collar and the skirt. So we cut the A-line skirt for this dress. Though I have shown you many methods, umbrella skirt, pleated skirt, gather skirt, you can use any type of skirt with this dress, with these bodies. So first of all, we check the length that we want for our skirt. will minus the bodies and rest of the length would be for our skirt. You can keep it as long or short for the skirt as you want. So we fold the fabric from the middle and we are cutting only the back skirt now. This is A-line. For A-line, the bottom we keep is 1/4 part of hips plus 1 inch. But for A-line, we need 2.5 inch extra from the sides. You can keep it like about 5 inches more from the sides. So that will be added bottom for you. Now cut it slightly curvier from the side, taking about 1 inch up from the sides, and then cut it same as the waist. Now we cut the front. I'm showing you two methods. One is simple. You can cut front and back same as A line and cut. Another is this method where you keep the back part of the skirt and then keeping this way that the front is open. Okay, you can cut the skirt. So using this method, you can add even buttons, loops, zipper, an opening on the front side of the skirt. Now I show you how to cut bell sleeves. See, while you make this dress, you can make even a kaftan and add a skirt, A-line skirt to that, and even that one would be okay. But that is not the right way, though that is also a way, and different people can make a dress in different methods, right? So that we fold the fabric, I show you how to make bell sleeve. We fold the fabric, back side of the fabric out, mark same armhole 7.5 inch as we have taken on the dress, 3 inch inside, that is 12th part of the chest. Then we go slightly slanting middle and 1/2 inch out curvier, and then slightly inside then out. Okay, now the bell sleeve is the bottom of the sleeve is wide, very wide, so you can keep it 15 inch 18 inch 20 inch, whatever your fabric allows, as much as fabric you have or as much as you want it to be loose. If you cut it on bias, that will make more sense. It will look much more flowy and more beautiful. But even this method would look good if you have limited fabric or you want this kind of a style as shown in the picture. Okay, so we just using slightly curvier, we join with our this line and take 1 inch out for the seams, and this is how we'll be cutting two sleeves. Sleeve cutting method would be similar, like simple one, like we use the tracing wheel, we cut the back curve of the sleeve then the front curve. But I show you another method too, where the, because these are summer times, you may or may not like the bell sleeves. So I'm making less loose sleeves. So here also the same method, armhole, that is 7.5 inch, 3 inch inside, slanting middle of that, then 1/2 inch out, and then out, then in, and then we go either straight up. You can make this way or you can go slightly curvier, whatever bottom width that you want. You can make it slightly curvier, and this way, this is also one of the method how you can make it. While talking about that blue sleeve, we'll be keeping the fabric on bias and then we'll be cutting that those sleeves asymmetrically. Like we won't be cutting them like this. If we keep the fabric the way we keep the fabric for umbrella skirt, our sleeves in any way, they would be asymmetrical or high and low from the bottom. I hope you like this method. In the next video, I'll show you how to join all these pieces, make the collar, complete this dress, and do let me know how did you like the video. You can press the thumbs up button to show that you like this video. So keep watching, stay subscribed, keep sharing, make this world a better place. Take care, bye-bye.